Microsoft dropped Swagger because of lack of maintenance. So when you create a project in .NET 9, you don't have Swagger anymore. The default URL that you see here, it is linked to your weather forecast. And that is this. So any project that you create in .NET 9, you're going to have this. This is not appealing at all. It is not developer friendly. In case you want to see all your endpoints, how are you going to do it? How can you interact with the API? Or you want to use maybe Postman or Insomnia? Well, what if in case if I told you that there's another replaceable package which works same as Swagger or even advanced than Swagger? Would you be happy? And would you want to integrate that and use it? Well, let's say the name is Scalar. So let's see how we can integrate it. Installing and integration is quite simple than using the Swagger. And when you have or when you take a look with the feature, it's amazing. Let's check it out. So this is what you need to do. Let's go and install this package. So in the dependencies, let's add and get packages. The name of the package is Scalar. So that is this package, scalar.aspnetcall. And now when you check here, so date published here was November 2024, right? Okay, so this is the published date. Now let's see. Let's go and install this package. So once we install, we can just even read the description, which says it generates beautiful interactive API documentation for api/swagger.document. All right, let's accept it. So the first step here is to install this package. The second step is to configure this in the program.cs file. So here you need to use or configure the middleware pipeline. No more services. So the middleware pipeline can decide to use it in a development stage or so. Let's put it out there. So all that you need to do here is to map Scalar API reference, and that is all. Now let's go and check it out. Once you have this running, you're going to navigate to a Scalar endpoint. And here, we're going to remove this weather forecast. And you're going to say that here, we need to pass in the Scalar/version 1. And that is all we need to do. We're going to have the nice interactive interface. Now we see this our controller. We have our bank app, and these are our controllers that we have. Currently, we have about 2 controllers, count and also weather forecast. All right. So by doing this, you have been able to integrate this Scalar Open API doc in your project. Do you want to know how you can use this? Then check out the next video, which talks about how you can create CRUD in .NET 9. So catch you up in the next video.